Welcome to Verse Breakdown. My name is Anwedewan Nomarin, and the verse for today is Joel chapter 3, verse 18, which reads, "And it shall come to pass in that day that the mountains shall drop down new wine, and the hills shall flow with milk, and all the rivers of Judah shall flow with waters, and the fountains shall come forth out of the house of the Lord, and shall water the valley of Shittim." The first three phrases about wine coming down from mountains and all that, those are not really going to be addressed that much in this video, but what we're really going to be talking about is the fountain that comes from the house of the Lord and how it will water the valley of Shittim. We're going to start by talking about Shittim, because it's not really one of those popular topics in the Bible. There are a couple of things that I want you to know about it. First of all, it is a fertile place. Now, this is only relevant because generally, for those who know geography, the Middle East is not really the most fertile area. It's pretty much desert, but Shittim was just kind of different, mainly because it was a valley and, you know, they were places with steep and high elevation around it, and because of that, water would kind of flow down from those areas, so the land would be fertile, and because of that, you could maybe farm there or generally do some stuff that you would do with fertile land. And also, that was the last destination that the Israelites encamped in before moving on to crossing the River Jordan, which would lead them to the land of Canaan. Now, Shittim is also really known for the atrocity that the Israelites committed there, but we're not really going to get into that in this video, mainly because Joel chapter 3 verse 18 wasn't really based on that. It was more based on the good side of Shittim, independent of what the Israelites did when they were in it. But anyway, essentially, spiritually speaking, Shittim kind of represents this world which the children of God live in. The fountain that's coming down from the house of the Lord represents how the saints who are appointed by God, if we read 1 John chapter 2, verse 27, Acts chapter 2, and other places, they preach the gospel. The gospel is like that fountain. It flows from, like, heavenness in a sense, by the apostles who receive it from God Almighty. They then preach it in this world, and it kind of waters this place because it brings forth fruit, children of God who are called by that message, that gospel message, if we read John chapter 6, verse 44. Jesus Christ told the apostles in Matthew chapter 24, verse 14, that they would preach the gospel all over the world. And there he said, "And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come." And as they would do that, then the gospel message would kind of attract some people who have good minds towards righteousness. There's that inside part of them that kind of makes a bond with that gospel, and then they respond positively to it by washing themselves clean with it. If you read Isaiah chapter 1 verse 16 and Ephesians chapter 5 verse 26. So they're watered by it in a sense, and that is the watering of the valley of Shittim. And this was kind of described in Isaiah chapter 2 verse 3, which not only mentions the house of the Lord, but it also gives some details as to what people would be saying, which kind of relates to watering. And there Isaiah the prophet told us, "And many people shall go and say, Come ye, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. And he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall come forth the law, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem." It's that same idea of God's word, the gospel, coming from heaven and watering us. That is, we're taught it, and then we begin to respond positively by living our lives accordingly. The Bible makes us note that the children of God will come from all over the world, but spiritually they are gathered before him. Not that they're going to be in a physical place, but to God they're kind of in that light. If we read Isaiah chapter 11 verse 12, where Isaiah the prophet once again said, "And he shall set up an ensign for the nations, and shall assemble the outcasts of Israel, and gather together the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth." And such ones who are gathered, if we're Genesis chapter 49 verse 10, are going to be the ones to inherit the earth, provided that they continue in that gospel. If we read Matthew chapter 5 verse 5, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. And that is where I'm going to stop on discussing that verse, Joel chapter 3, verse 18, which once again reads, "And it shall come to pass in that day, that the mountains shall drop down new wine, and the hills shall flow with milk, and all the rivers of Judah shall flow with waters, and the fountains shall come forth out of the house of the Lord, and shall water the valley of Shittim." If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. And also, if you have any questions about this verse, don't forget to ask them in the comment section below. This is one of those powerful quotations that can be misinterpreted and generally not understood. So if you are confused by the way we might have interpreted it, just ask it in the comment section below and we will try to respond to your questions. Have a great day and God bless you.